Thank you for clicking on the video. Welcome back to the channel. This is a review for Power Book 2, Season 2, Episode 4, Getting These Ends. Carrie out in the woods. I don't know why she out in the woods. It's dark and she in the woods. But anyway, she waiting on Zeke. She texts him trying to figure out where he is. And she gets back in her car. And she gets a text from Zeke that says, almost here. And then her window is busted open and it's Monet. Bitch, didn't I tell you to stop fucking my nephew? And you still did it. You still wouldn't listen. Now you gonna talk. What you know about this man? What you know about this professor nigga dying? What you know about that? What you know about it? She's like, did you have him killed? Of course, Carrie is like, no. And she's like, I was with Zeke at the apartment. Like, when Jabari was killed, we ain't had nothing to do with it. Monet tells her, you gonna find out who did it. You gonna find out who killed Jabari, and not finding the culprit ain't an option. And if you come up short, you're gonna have more problems than losing your job. Just letting you know. Okay, Davis and Sax are looking at cars, you know, McLarens and Maseratis and Ferraris. They're looking at cars. And Tariq is on his way to their office. He gets a text from Kane. Don't forget about me, Silver Spoon. What's the score on Zeke? on Zeke. Okay, he drops in there. And he tells them, you know, that he needs them to do everything that they can to get Zeke, to keep Zeke out of jail. He alleges, though, that the police, you know, have potentially maybe covered something up. And he mentions that the murder weapon was registered to an NYPD officer, Ramirez. And so Detective Sax, you know, he's still got the prosecution type of lens. He's looking from a prosecution lens and not defense attorney, because Davis is like, listen, why are you asking all them questions? We don't need to know none of that. Why is you asking all the questions? All we need to know is how much you gonna pay. That's all Davis care about is the check. He want to know why he's so invested in Zeke's issues and all of that. Listen, he tells them, he's the reason I'm here. If he don't stay in school, I don't stay in school. So that's what this is about. I need y'all to make it right. Thank you very much. Because listen, Monet will pay. Don't you worry about that. She'll pay for it. Sax, like I said, he still got his prosecution hat on. And Davis is like, listen, you need to stop asking questions and focus on the bag. Because that's all we care about. Detective Kevin Overzealous and Carrie, they run into each other at Stansfield. They're both headed into a meeting with the dean. Tate is also there serving as a liaison. And he's actually replacing Carrie because that used to be her job. Detective Kevin Overzealous want to know why he's there. And then Simon stands up and Simon is like, I asked you to be present because I got questions. I want to know why you targeting my star athlete Ezekiel Cross. Why are we doing that? What evidence do you have on him? And, you know, they all want some concrete evidence. We need to know what the facts are. We need the facts of the case. Please and thank you. Since you just got him as your prime suspect, Tate jumps in and adds, you know, that they've looked into Zeke and there's nothing, not even a traffic violation. So what makes him your prime suspect? Carrie's just like, they don't have no evidence. And the detective, Kevin Overzealous, says, no, but we got motive. And then Tate chimes in because he's petty and says, so Carrie, what motive does Zeke have? She changes the subject completely. And she's like, oh, I've been meaning to tell y'all. So Jabari was looking into, he was helping the folks on the GTG boy murder. You know, that was they were drug dealers, and then we got a drug pipeline going on at the school. And Jabari was, you know, in the midst with all of that. And as far as interrogating the students, Detective Kevin Overzealous says, you know, if this will be all, you know, any other information y'all got, you can share it with his department. And Simon is like, and if we don't find anything worthwhile, I'll need you to go away. And Detective Kevin Overzealous is like, I don't take orders from you, sir. Everybody takes orders from me. And I'll be sure to let the commissioner know that when we have dinner this evening. You don't take orders from me. Was that it for that little interaction?
Yeah.
Yep, that was it. Okay. After their meeting, Tate pulls Carrie aside and he tells her that, you know, he knows that Zeke is innocent. And he also knows that she and the detective, Kevin Overzealous, have history as well. So he kind of like, you know, trolls her a little bit, laughs at the fact that she just unslept with everybody. It's like, so is Jabari, is Z, Detective Kevin Overzealous. Girl, you got a lot going on. Listen, I love to see it. She urges him, though, to, you know, look into seeing, because she already is on the chopping block herself. So she got to find some help in proving Zeke's innocence. And so she's like, aren't you, you know, aren't you for the people? Aren't you the black, you know, hero? You know, you're our hero, whatever. You're going to come in and save the day. So save the day. That's how you win elections. You know, figure out, find a way to prove Zeke's innocence. That's how you win elections, brother. And she give him a little pat on the back and keep on walking. Davis meets with Monet. He say he want $1 million. $1 million. And she say, you know, she going to pay it. She going to pay it. So she try to go to the safe because he met her at the bar. She goes to the safe to get it, but it's empty. Ain't nothing in there but guns. And he tells her that she has 3 days, you know, to get him the money and he'll get to work. Monet, she done went and found the contractors that were there and she done tortured him. His ear sitting next to him on the ground in the gravel. She got the gun to his head and he's steady saying he don't know what happened. He don't know where the money is. He don't got it. And she's like, listen, I'm going to ask you one more time. Where is my money? And he says he don't know. And she just shoots him. Wrong answer. Wrong answer. She get home and, you know, she tell the kids what happened and what's going on. And they don't know who took it either. Everybody but Diana. Diana sitting up there looking guilty. Monet tells him that they're going to have to help her get the money back, of course. And because they want to hire Davis. And it's $1 million. He is crazy. Diana, she sneaks and on her way out, she sneaks and texts Davis and asks if he can transfer the money she gave him for Lorenzo's case over to Zeke's. And he's like, absolutely not. Already in motion for your father. Not happening. Tariq and Lauren, they walking in class holding hands. And I was like, psh, get out of here. It was just so cheesy. Walking in class holding hands. Sitting down at the desk holding hands. Will y'all please? Y'all act like y'all in high school with this. Anyway, of course, we're in class now. So, of course, we got some big topic to talk about. They were talking about, an assignment that they had to complete a paper. And Tate was just, you know, telling the class that he thinks that they all did a good job. Everybody but Tariq. He felt like Tariq didn't really answer the question. So, you know, they all throw their ideas around. Sax's little sneaky link and Tate's brother, they're on the case now with Detective Kevin Overzealous, and he is still sure that Zeke is his prime suspect. Tate's brother want to know, you know, we all want to know, what are the facts? What are the facts to support all of this? And he just says it's motive, and Tate's brother brings up his report where he originally listed the murder weapon to be that, you know, belonging to Detective Ramirez. And Detective Kevin Overzealous is saying that he stole the gun from him. Zeke, that is. That Zeke done stole the gun from him. And that's, you know, because he had his PBA card and all. You know, he's just running with his baseless claims. Okay, Kane, he meets up with Mecca Dante. And, you know, he's like, what's going on? You know, what would make you jeopardize your position with me? And he tells him, you know, I got to get $1 million in 3 days from my cousin Zeke. He's family. So, listen, we got to do it. Mecca Dante understands and gives him an opportunity and tells him, listen, my competition, I got an opportunity for you. We're going to kill two birds with one stone. So, my competition is trying to move in on my territory and I need him gone. And once he's gone, I need you to go to all his fronts and bring all his money to me. I'll send you the address. I dropped the location. And whatever, he tells him, whatever he gets, you know, over 50K, what's left he can, you know, put aside for Zeke. Tariq, he walk in campus and he's texting Lauren, you know, where you at? And she ain't answer. Then he gets a call from Yaz. Yaz want to know when you come. When you coming to get me, Tariq? Tariq, when are you coming to get me? Can you buy me one of the, please, with this girl here. I don't know where they be finding the child actors on Power, but I know it's somebody better. I know it is. Anyway. Brayden, he gets to the room and Kane is there. Kane kind of plays this Jedi mind trick on him. And now Brayden is going out on a run with him. And he tells him he's going to be his driver tonight. Sax with the sneaky link. And she's trying to figure out why Tate is there. You know, like, what's his angle? Why all of a sudden is his brother on the case? Like, you know, Rashad Tate, Lorenz Tate. He don't do nothing without some type of political gain, you know, in, you know, for him, in his favor. And Sax tells her that she should use all of this to her advantage, you know, get on his good side, you know. When she steps away, he goes through the case notes and sees that the police have Ramirez's gun and a bolo has been issued. So that's going to get leaked later. We already know that. Detective Tate 2.0 has Lauren in the interrogation room after finding pills in her room. You know, of course, the pill. And I'm like, y'all ain't finding the blunt, too, because light-skinned Keisha put a blunt and some pills in there. Let me find out. Sis went back to their room and smoked that blunt while she was on some. Is that weed? Because they just had the pills sitting there. I guess that maybe they don't care about the weed. But anyway. They basically want her to snitch on somebody. Who is the supplier? Who you getting it from? Who's selling the drugs? And she's like, I don't know. Carrie comes in and, you know, she has to drop in and pull Tate aside. And she tells him, you know, that he needs to go at the drug pipeline hard. But remember, like, these students don't know you. They don't trust you. You're not going to get it like that. So she suggests going in and being good cop. And, cause she was a cop before. We didn't know that. I thought she was a prosecution attorney. And she was a cop, too. Listen, sis always been around here snitching. She convinces Lauren to help the police, you know. And the incentive is that, you know, there will be nothing on her record. Nothing will come back to her. Her parents won't find out. It'll all be wiped clean as it relates to her. But they're going to need her to wear a wire. And she agrees. They're going to put it in a Rolex. Tariq. He's with Elvin. You know, the lawyer, the estate lawyer, and Elvin, he wants his support in trying to get custody of Yaz. And Elvin kind of laughing it off, like a little bit like, boy, whatever. But Tariq is dead serious. So like he threatens to go to court and have him like disbarred or something, like have him removed completely. Like he threatens him, and so the estate attorney is like, okay, you got my support. He changes his tune very quickly. Brayden, he on the ride with Kane. Kane go to this trap house to kill Mecca's competition. This guy come out to the car with his gun behind his back like, who you know here? And Brayden gonna say, what he say? Bobby, Ricky. No way. He said, oh, you know, Ronnie, Bobby, Ricky, and Mike. That's who he know. Anyway, then they hear gunshots. And so Kane is in there shooting up the place. And then they throw the money out the window. And they take off. Monet, she having her conjugal visit with Lorenzo. And she asked him to sign off on mortgaging the house. She gonna put that house up. You know, like she need that million for Zeke. Lorenzo say, I'm sorry, girl. I can't help you. You know, like if it was one of our children, of course. But sorry. I mean, I know you love your nephew. But we can't help him this time. We can't help him. And he ain't budging on that. He say, that's the bottom line. I'm not signing it. I'm not doing it. Monet just leaves. At the house, both Drew and Zeke, you know, sitting around pouting because they stuck in the house. Drew texting Everett and asks him, does he think the team would be willing to do something for Zeke? You know, of course, he's like, what do you have in mind? So, Drew say he gonna take care of it himself. Everett and Drew, they finish hunching. And, they look at the social media. They see, you know, it's people that got, they got hit. So the team went live and, you know, did some kind of boycott video. Like they're not going to play the next game until Zeke is exonerated. And they also created a GoFundMe for him. So they did their part. Then Everett tells him, because he in the sharing mood, he tells Drew that he might have mentioned to a few of Zeke's professors or a few people, you know, what really happened the night that they got jumped. And I'm like, what? He ain't the one, Drew. He ain't the one. Because he around here running his mouth. He is not the one. No. Okay, Effie and Diana, they looking like two city girls in this in a designer store, some store. Let's say Chanel. So they're traipsing through Chanel. They getting ready to use some stolen credit cards to buy some clothes to sell back to a booster and get them some coins. So they in there to shop. While they're in there, Effie in there giving dating tips to Diana, you know, warning her not to fool around with Tariq. Like, don't sleep with him, girl. Do not fuck him, because it's gonna complicate things. You do not want that heartbreak. Trust me when I tell you, okay, sis? Trust me from experience. Don't go down that road. Wrong road. Okay, Zeke, he's sitting on the porch when a reporter walks up with his phone out recording. And, you know, he's asking him all these questions, talking about Zeke being accused of murder and his Uncle Lorenzo being in prison for manslaughter. And so it's safe to say, hey, Eden, it's safe to say that, okay, it's safe to say that murder runs in the family. And Drew walks up, you know, and he's like, what? And what? And he just hits the man, just straight up cold cocks him. Keep my daddy name out your mouth. Fuck. Zeke got to just pull him away on down the street. Cause he, listen, that don't make, they are continuously making this hole deeper and deeper and deeper for Zeke. Like continuously. At the house, they ain't come up with nearly enough of the money. You know, he pour out the money out that bag and it's just nothing. It's just nothing. It's like maybe three or four bands just there. And they need a whole lot more. They need a million. Of course, Monet fussing. She lashes out at Drew for punching the man at the curb. And Drew feeling really unappreciated right now. Because he say, I'm the one that got the GoFundMe. I done got the team involved. Like, I'm the one who raised most of the money. What you talking about? See, this is why I can't. And he just leaves. Davis Method Man walking in the door as he's leaving out. And Davis tells them, you know, that the reporter is not going to press charges and he's not going to do it unless Zeke does an interview with Jamel Hill. So he has to do that. Okay, Tariq, he in his room when Braden comes in. You know, he's just checking in on Tariq and he tells him, you know, you can't be pillow talking with Lauren. I know y'all together now, but don't be pillow talking. Don't be letting her know what we got going on. Tariq is way ahead of him. You know, he's not going to, he knows how to keep the two separate. He got bigger fish to fry anyway. And then he shows him a CCTV clip of Big Mama at the liquor store buying up cases of liquor. And then we see Yaz come in the liquor store and Mama get upset and like shakes her. And we see Yaz fall to the floor. So he gonna send that footage to whomever he needs to send it to so he can get custody of Yaz. It's just like, damn, Tariq, that's your grandma. He don't care. Just like his daddy. The bottom line is what I want and what I need to happen. Never mind everybody else, all the casualties. Who cares? Who cares? Okay, Braden, he mentions getting a pizza or whatever and having a few drinks with Tariq. And then he gets a text from Kane. And now he can't do it. Now he need a rain check. Talking about he going to go study with a study partner. Just lying. Then we see Tariq send the footage to a Daniel Warren. We don't know who that is. Braden, he pulls up on this like jewelry store. gets out and, you know, he's distracting the guy. He begged the guy to get in there and said, you know, says it's a last minute gift that he needs. And when he's inside, of course, Kane busts in there and pop, pop, pop. You know, he took out all the cameras, and then Braden pulled his gun like, oh, don't do it. Don't think about it. So now, you know, they got to clear the place out. They're in there busting the cases and getting all the jewelry. And the, what's the man? The man that works there, he sees, you know, that Braden gets just a little distracted and he goes to try to reach for his gun. And then Braden picks up his gun and tries to shoot it, but it jams. And so he just hits him upside the head, like, the gun jammed. And Kane is like, yeah, I jammed it. Can't have you out here shooting folks, Tom Cruise. So that's that. He's like, listen, you here to help, you know, and looks and, you know, help me get in places. I'm using you, okay? I don't really need you out here shooting people. Detective Kevin Overzealous and Saxis Boo and Tate 2.0 meet up. Tate 2.0 say he got proof that Zeke's alibi checks out. They got him on camera at a bodega, so he could not have been doing it. He at the bodega at the time. Just like he said. Detective Kevin Overzealous then checked into Ramirez himself and found that, you know, he has a sketchy track record, you know, so he got money, funny money somewhere like that can't be traced or tracked or anything like that. His theory is that Zeke hired Ramirez to kill Zeke and Ramirez left town afterwards. Tate 2.0 says, okay, so how are you going to prove that? At the house, Davis and Tariq are there to help Zeke, of course, before his interview with Jemele Hill. He was able to get the questions, you know, so they look over the questions and Tariq is like, listen, I need you to stick to the script. Don't say nothing I ain't write down. You need to say all the responses I give you. That's what you need to say, word for word, verbatim. Don't play with me. Do not do it. Okay, then we pan over to his interview. Wait, did we do that yet? I don't want to skip nothing. Yeah, now we at the interview. Carrie and Tate are watching it. Tariq and Lauren are watching it. The Tate 2.0, Saxis, Sneaky Link, they watching it all in one. Everybody watching it. Everybody watching it. Tariq and Lauren watching it from their room, too. She wired up, too. She got that watch on. Oh, heifer. Anyway, Zeke is doing pretty good at first, you know, sticking to the script. Then Jemele goes off script, and now she asking all these questions that he wasn't ready for. And she asked him if he knew that they found the murder weapon, you know, at the scene, and it was a gun that was registered to a DeMello Ramirez. And Zeke is like, immediately like, what? With that dumb look on his face. Ramirez? I don't know a Ramirez. I don't know him. I don't. And she's like, oh, really? That's funny. That's funny because we heard from a source that during your interrogation, you brought up Ramirez's name. You had his PBA card. Can you explain that? Oh, Detective Ramirez. Oh, he always come to my games all the time. Yeah, he a fan. He come to my games. Oh, he's a fan. So we looked into his whereabouts as well as your team's, and he's never been at your games. Man, this is some bullshit. And he get up and, you know, now he don't want to talk no more. And now he got to just go. Just fight or flight. And it makes him look bad. Everybody in there like, oh, shit. Monet like, go get him. David's like, if I go get him, that's going to make him look guilty. Like, he can't do nothing. She backed him into a complete corner. And there was no way for him to get out. Afterwards, Jemele, she ain't got no sympathy for nobody. She say, I'm a journalist. Okay, period. Sorry. Good luck. Zeke walks in looking cheap. I mean, cheap as fuck. Cheap, cheap. Davis gets a text from the DA's office. They want him to turn himself in. So there's that. Okay, he got to turn himself in the morning. Kane, he done slipped out, but not quick enough because Monet on his heels and she catches him outside before he about to pull off. You and me, we need to talk right now. Meet me over there at the park. Now, I'm going to follow you. So they get over there to the park. And he tells her everything. He tells her everything that, you know, he and Tariq did. And she slaps him. He's like, I hope you got that same energy for Tariq. And then she's like, you let me worry about Tariq. Don't you worry about what I'm going to do with Tariq. I got Tariq. He told her everything. And she slaps him. He wants her to keep that same energy for Tariq. But she tells him that, you know, she's going to deal with him when the time comes. Right now, I need you to go and get Ramirez's body. And when CSI figures out that he was killed way before Jabari's death, that just rules him out altogether. And, you know, Zeke will be in the clear. And Kane is like, but what if it falls back on me, Ma? I guess you should have thought about that, huh? I'm so sorry, baby. I can't help you. It is what it is at this point. When he leaves, she gets a text from Davis saying that Zeke's bill has been paid in full, you know, so he's officially on the case. Tariq, he's in his room and Big Mama come knocking. Tariq James St. Patrick, open this door right now. So he let her in and she drunk boots, of course. She done been served, and so now she mad about that. And, you know, he tells her, I can't let Yaz stay with you like this. Like, let me help you pay for rehab. And she pushes him away and tells him every evil thing that has befallen this family is because of you. You, Tariq. And she says she'll die first before she let him have that grandbaby. See you in court. So that's that. Kane, he's driving and he gets a call from Mecca. You know, he's showing his gratitude to Kane for his help, you know, and getting competition. How the hell I couldn't think of the competition. Anyway, he's showing him gratitude for getting the competition out of there or whatever. And then Kane tells him that he's going to need to make a big drop for his cousin. And then he got to leave town for a while. So he ain't going to really be around. And Mecca's like, what? You know, he already know what's up. I don't know how Mecca got his ears to the streets because he know everything. But anyway, he asks, you know, if there's anybody else that he can pin it on when it comes down to it. And Kane just has this look on his face, you know. He got somebody in mind that he can frame. You already know. It's just a contingency plan, if you will. Okay, Drew, he drops by Everett's room. Everett saw the interview, and he believes Zeke is guilty. You know, he's like, you was up in here fool-la-lying with me, and you knew your cousin was guilty? And, of course, Drew is like, you know, it's not true and all of that. And, you know, he tells him, I'm going to let you do this one time, and one time only you can ask me a question about my family. Just this once, because Drew say he wants it to work out with Everett. And Everett asks, okay, is your family involved in Jabari's murder? No. Okay, is your family involved in drugs? I don't trust you with that answer. See, I cannot. And you know that he tell him he got his back. He say he got his back. He gonna be ride or die. He's down. Monet, she goes to see Mecca Dante, and he's the one that paid Kiki. He's the one that paid Zeke's bill. Monet is upset, of course. You know, she's like, how am I supposed to explain this to my husband? And he like, I don't know what you're going to say. And I really don't care. He really don't care. He says, maybe you can tell him that you did whatever you had to do to protect our son. Y'all, Zeke is his son, not Cain. I knew one of them folk with his churn. I knew it. I know it. I knew it. I really did. I didn't think it was going to be Zeke. Now, that threw me for a loop completely because I wasn't expecting for Zeke to be his child. Zeke? Nah, wasn't expecting that one. But it makes a lot of sense why she's so protective of him and why. Because it's like, where is his mama? That's your nephew. Where is his mama? Where's his daddy? Where's the rest of where are his people? Nah, cause that's you had that child in high school and somebody else raised him. And then once he became an adult, you got him back as a nephew. You know, you look out and have everybody else look out, and y'all just ride his coattails to the sunset. This is why she don't want him involved in the drug business. But it's like, is it because it's she and Mecca's child, why she don't want him involved and only wants him doing basketball? Because her children with Lorenzo, they in the business. So, I don't know. But that's their son together. And he tells her, you know, that she can be a woman if she's with him. You know, she ain't got to be a trap queen. She ain't got to struggle and hustle for money. Money won't be an issue. Not an issue at all. He will provide the lifestyle that she wants to live without all of the mess involved. Like, she wouldn't have to get her hands dirty and none of that. He got her. Girl, going on with this man now. Because Lorenzo in prison forever. So, it's about time you serve Lorenzo with some papers. That's what I'm thinking. That's what I'm thinking, because the helicopter rides, the rented out restaurants, and this big ass mansion. He just dropping a million here and there. Listen, that sounds about right. That's up here. Lorenzo in prison, way down here. Don't nobody want to keep doing conjugal visits when the man right here in the flesh. Girl, you know what to do. You know what to do, Auntie Mary Monet. Okay, Kane and Brayden, they go get Ramirez's body out the swamp. Tariq, he goes back to Lauren's room. She says she gonna keep his mind off of, you know, the bad day he's had. When they start kissing or whatever and removing clothes, it gets caught on, her shirt gets caught on her watch, and he notices, oh, you got you, that's a nice Rolex. Your parents bought you a new Rolex. Oh, yeah. Just give me a minute. I'll be right back. And she gonna go in the bathroom and take the Rolex off. I said, girl, keep the Rolex on since you the snitch now. Go on, keep it on. You're supposed to go in there to get more comfortable, take off your clothes so that he's not on to you. You come back out there with the watch missing, and I'm gonna be like, why she took that watch off? Mm-hmm. He not stupid, girl. He's gonna notice that. So I don't know. I don't know about you, Lauren. I don't know about you. And I wonder if she hears anything about Tariq being involved in Course Correct or Brayden or whatever. What's she going to do? Are you going to tell on them people? What you going to do? Anyway. Detective Kevin Overzealous is in his office, and Tate 2.0 drops by with the lead. He say he done found something in Jabari's journal, you know, that you might want to see. Detective Kevin Overzealous gets a call about Ramirez's body being found, so he got to go. Excuse me. At the scene, the CSI, they tell them that the person has been dead for about 2 weeks. They couldn't ID the body off the, you know, facial recognition alone because the body is too badly decomposed. But they found his badge on him, you know, that says Detective, what's his name? The somebody. I don't remember his name. Detective Ramirez. That's who it is. So they have their person. When Brayden and Kane get back to the room, Brayden beelines for the bathroom, start throwing up. And I was thinking, did you hold all of that, the whole car ride? You, like, it would make more sense to throw up right there at the scene, and then they done found your throw up, test it, and find out it's you. Like, I was thinking I was going down that road, and these people going down a whole different road. I don't know what's finna happen, but Brayden ain't had a stomach for that. So he in there throwing up, and while he's doing that, Kane takes his opportunity to plant Ramirez's badge, and he plants it in Tariq's drawer. So I thought he was about to set up Brayden. Nah, he about to say he really don't like Tariq. And I think it's because Tariq is the rich boy. He's the rich boy, Silver Spoon, as he called him, calls him. Like, he don't really feel like he about that life, but it's like, he is. Do you not know who his daddy is? Yeah, he had the Silver Spoon, but daddy was a whole kingpin. So, like, he got some of the traits now, Kane. I'm going to need for you to stop giving Tariq so much. Like, he's just, you know, square. Anyway, he tells him, listen, y'all, hey, tell Tariq I'll be seeing him. Yeah, he going to be seeing him because as soon as Tariq sees that badge and finds that badge in his drawer, yeah, he going to be back around there to see Kane and see what's up. And it's going to be a problem. I already know. Kane might as well just go on and ride out. I mean, that they don't even do nothing really with his storyline. So, like, do we really even need... I mean, Kane is nice to look at. Don't get it twisted. But his role on the show, it's almost like it's coming to a close. I don't know. It just seems like it is. Okay, that's it, guys. Be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe to the channel. It's Call Me Busby, and I'm going to chat with y'all later. Peace and light.